Hello, welcome to Math 1350, a video lesson for Chapter 2, Section 2. Section 2 deals with sets. A set is a collection of elements. Listed in side brackets, separated by commas. So, for example, the set of vowels. Call that S. The name of sets are always capital. When we see the bracket, it means it's a list. It's a set of elements. So we have A, E, I, O, U. Here's a set. All right. So again. Elements are listed in lowercase representations, and then the set name is in capital. All right, so here we talk about elements and sets. The number of elements in a set is called the cardinality or the cardinal number. And it's represented like this. This N represents the cardinality, and inside there is what set you're looking at. When we compare sets, two sets are equal if and only if and only if both sets have exactly the same elements and cardinality. They have the same elements and the same number of elements. Those are two equals. Two sets are similar if they have the same cardinality. In other words, if they have the same number of elements inside there. A subset is a set that can contain all or some or no elements of another set. So, for example, if I had set A, A, E, I, and I have the set of vowels, A, E, I, O, U, then we say that A is a subset of S. But more so, since it doesn't equal the same number of elements, or it doesn't have the same number of elements, we say that is A is a proper subset of S. But if so, what that symbol would use would be A is a subset, proper subset of S. This would be the more accurate one. We'll reserve that one U, then A is a subset. So proper subsets at least one element missing. Subsets can have all the way up to it. Elements inside a set. Symbol. We say that, for example, here earlier we have A so the elements of A are contained in elements of A are elements contained in S, in set S. Not contained or part, contained in or part of. And if two sets are equal, is it? If two sets are equal, they have the same cardinality and the same number of elements. Determining of subsets and proper subsets possible. The number of subsets possible . This is the number of elements. So the formula is 2 to the power n. proper subsets, but it's got to have at least one difference. So there's that formula, where n, again, is this number of elements. So look at an example of that one. Say S contains letters A, B, C. N represents the number of elements, which is also the cardinality of S. So in this case, it's 3. Number of subsets. 2 to the power n, which is 2 to the power 3, which is 8. Number of proper subsets. 2 to the power n minus 1. 2 to the power 3 minus 1. 8 minus 1. There are 7 possibilities. Let's look at these and the homework problems now.